Good morning, guys. And today is 19th January, Tuesday. And our topic of discussion today is about Indian drainage system. All right, guys. So be ready for the lesson of the day. Okay. All the best ahead. Let's begin with our Indian drainage system. So first here, we have introduction part of it. Let's have a look at the introductory part of it. What it says? It says the flow of water through well-defined channel is known as drainage. Okay, and the network of such channels is known as called your drainage system. The drainage pattern of an area is the result of the geological time period, nature and structure of rocks, topography, slope, etc. Here you can have a better view of our drainage system with the help of this picture here, which I put for you. Okay, let's see what the next point is saying. It is about 77% of drainage area consisting of Ganga, the Brahmaputra, the Mahanadi, the Krishna, etc. is oriented towards the Bay of Bengal. Okay, about how much? 77% of it. Okay, made up of Ganga, Brahmaputra, Mahanadi, Krishna. Okay, and it is oriented towards Bay of Bengal. The point number next says that on the other hand, the 23%. Okay, comprising of the Indus, the Narmada and Tapi and the Mahanadi, the Periyar system discharge their waters in the Arabian Sea. Okay, this Periyar one is, you know, Kerala. Alright. Next point it says, a river drain is a specific area which is known as catchment area of that river. An area drained by a river and its tributaries is known as called drainage basin. Okay, you should know all this important thing, that what is catchment area, what is drainage basin. Okay, the boundary line separating one drainage basin from the other is called your watershed area. Okay, next we have our drainage pattern. It says the following are the major drainage patterns. Okay, first one is your dendritic, second is radial, third is centripetal, and the fourth is trellis. Now what these are, we will see them one by one. A drainage pattern which looks like tree branches, okay, how it looks like tree branches with lots of twigs is known as your dendritic drainage pattern. For example, the river of your northern plains, these are the example of a dendritic drainage pattern. The second one is your radial drainage pattern, from when the rivers, these are forms when the rivers originate from a hill, okay, and flows in all the directions. Okay, for example, the river originating from Amarkantak is an example of your radial drainage pattern. Okay, the third one is says the centripetal drainage pattern. Okay, which is formed when the river discharges their waters from all directions into a lake or depression. Okay, for example, Loktak Lake in Manipur. Okay, and the last one is your terrils drainage pattern is formed when the primary tributaries of main river. Okay, the primary tributary of main river flow parallel to each other and secondary tributaries join them at right angles. For example, the rivers of the upper part of Himalayan region, these are the examples of your terrial drainage pattern. Okay, further guys, we have the classification of drainage system on the basis of the mode of origin, nature and characteristic. The Indian drainage is classified as Himalayan drainage and the second one is known as called your peninsular drainage. Okay, so let's see ahead about these points. Now guys, here is the one map of India which is showing the rivers of India, and you guys need to see this carefully because geography is not something you can just simply mug up. Map plays a vital role to learn anything. Okay, so if you will look at the major rivers and areas over here, like we have here the Buller Lake over here and your Indus, Jhelum, Chenab, Ravi and Satluj, these are the rivers. Okay, and then here we have the Govind Sagar Dam, and this side is your Ganga River, this is your Yamuna River, alright, Gangotri. Okay, this Gandak, okay, Koshi, okay. This side here we have your Brahmaputra. Okay, and if you come little this side here, this is your Yamuna, this is your Chambal River is over here. Okay, and further if you go, this is your Narmada here, Narmada Tapi. Okay, this is Godavari, this is Krishna. Okay, so these are some of the important rivers of India, which you need to see, that Brahmaputra, this is your Ganga River. Guys, now further we are talking about the Himalayan drainage system, what it is. The major Himalayan drainage system are the Indus, the Ganga and the Brahmaputra rivers. Okay, this include this Indus, Ganga and the Brahmaputra that comes under the Himalayan drainage system. Okay, the total length, if you look at the Indus, the total length of Indus River system is around 2,880 kilometers. Okay, and in India, it is 1,114 kilometer. As you can see over here, this is from where the Indus is originated and how it moves. Can you see this is Indus River over here, right? So this is what some part is in India and some is in Pakistan. Okay, further it says the Indus, which is also known as your Sindhu, is the westernmost of the Himalayan rivers in India. Now in this figure you can see here the some of the major rivers which are flowing in the Himalayan, which is originating from the Himalayas. Okay, so now see this is how they flow. These rivers are, here is your Indus, okay, this is your Jhelum, then next to Chenab, Ravi, Bias, okay, and this is your Satluj. Okay, so these are the major 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Because of these five, it is Punjab has got its name also, right? Okay, the Indus originates from a glacier near Bokharchu in the Tibetan region at an altitude of about 4,664. Okay, this is where the Indus River originated. Okay, in the Kailas mountain range. Okay, in Tibet, the Indus is known as Singi Kamban. Okay, or the lion's mouth. The Indus enters into Pakistan near Chilar in the Dardistan region. Okay, next look at the next point. It says the major tributaries. Okay, tributaries are the small rivers which join the main river. So, for those who don't know, the major tributaries of Indus are the Shyok, the Gilgit, Jaskar, Hunza, Nubra, Shigar, Gusting, Dras. Okay, this is in the upper part. In the lower part, if you will see, which are there? So the Sutluj, Bias, Ravi, Chenab, Jhelum. Okay, these are the major tributaries of Indus River. Okay, finally the Indus discharges into Arabian Sea near Karachi in Pakistan. The Jhelum. If you will talk about Jhelum, the Jhelum, an important tributary of Indus, rises from the spring at Virinag, situated at the foothill of Pir Panjal. The Jhelum flows through Srinagar and the Wooler Lake from before entering into the Pakistan. Okay, the Jhelum River flows Srinagar. Okay, before entering to the Pakistan, Jhelum joins the Chenab near Jang in Pakistan. Okay, now formed by the two streams, that is the Chandra and the Baga. The Chenab is the largest tributary of Indus. Okay, which is the largest tributary of Indus is Chenab. Chenab is also known as called your Chandra Baga. Okay, the Chenab flows about 1180 kilometers before entering into the Pakistan. Means how much it flows into India is this much. Now originating from Rohtang Pass, okay, in Kullu Hills of Himachal Pradesh and flowing through the Chamba Valley of the state, Ravi is one of the important tributaries of Indus. Originating from Bias Kund near Rohtang Pass at an elevation of around 4000 meter above the main sea level, Bias is also an important tributary of the Indus. Bias enters Punjab plains and meet with Satluj near Harike, also popular as Langchen Kambab in Tibet. The Satluj originated from the Rakas Lake near Mansarovar at an altitude of around 4,555 meter in Tibet. Okay. The Satluj passes through the Shipikla on the Himalayan regions and enters into the Punjab plains. Okay. The Satluj is the river that feeds the canal system of Bhakra Nagal project. Okay, so they may ask you that which river feeds water to the Bhakra Nagal project, so that your answer should be Satluj. Okay, now we are talking about the Ganga. Okay, and some of them they call it as the Ganges also. The Ganga originates from the Gangotri Glacier near Gomukh. Okay, that is around, Ganga originates from Gangotri Glacier, okay, near Gomukh, 3900 meter in the Uttarkashi district of Uttarakhand. Okay, this is where the origination of Ganga is. Now guys, in this map you can see the area which is drained by the Ganges River and its tributaries. Okay, this is the source of Ganga is over here. Alright, and this is how the Ganga flows, and these all are the small tributaries of it, as you can see here, right? These are the tributaries to the river Ganges. Alright, and this is how it flows through, right? It shows the direction over here, as you can see, right? Okay, next point, it said that however the river when river Ganges, it originates from Gangotri Glacier, is known as called Bhagirathi. At Devprayag, the Bhagirathi merges with another river that is Alaknanda, and from here it is known as the Ganga. The Alaknanda originates from Satopant Glacier above Badrinath. The major tributaries of the Alaknanda are the Dhauli and the Vishnu Ganga. Okay, and these two rivers meet at Josimath and Vishnu Prayag. Okay, some other tributaries of Alaknanda are the Pindar. Okay, and the Mandakini and Kali Ganga. The total length of Ganga in India is around 2,525 kilometer, which is shared by Uttarakhand, that is 110 kilometer. Okay, Uttar Pradesh, it flows around 1,450 kilometer, means a major part of it of Ganga River flows into Uttar Pradesh. Okay, and then it comes Bihar, that is 445 kilometer, and West Bengal 520 kilometer, means a big part of Ganga is flowing in Uttar Pradesh, and then it is in West Bengal. Okay, and then it is in Bihar at number 3, and then last it's Uttarakhand. Okay, so these are the 1, 2, 3, and 4 major states through which river Ganges flows. Okay, next point says the Ganga river system is the largest river system in India. The Sun is a major right bank tributary of the Ganga. Okay, what's his name? The Sun. Okay, right bank tributary of Ganga. However, major left bank tributaries of the Ram Ganga, Gomti, Ghagra, Gandak, Koshi and Mahanadi, originating from Yamunotri Glacier on the western slopes of Banderpunch range, the Yamuna is the longest tributary of river Ganga. The Yamuna joins the Ganga at where? Which place? Allahabad in Prayag, okay, Uttar Pradesh, that is. Okay, further it says the Chambal rises near Mohu in Malwa Plateau of Madhya Pradesh. The Chambal is famous for its bedland topography known as Chambal Ravines. Okay. Now guys, this is what you can see in this picture, right? This is known as called your bedland topography. Okay. And this is known as called your Chambal Ravines. Okay. This is how this uplifted part, right? And you must have heard about the Phulan Devi when she was a dacoit. So she used to hide in this particular bedland topography. So it was difficult for police to and others to identify their hiding places, etc. Okay, let's see what's point next point says. It said, originating from Nepal Himalayas between the Dholgiri and the Mount Everest, the Gandak consists of two streams, namely Kali Gandak and Trishul Ganga. Okay, the Gandak joins the Ganga at Sonpur near Patna, Bihar. The Ghagar originates from Mapchuchungo Glacier and joins the Ganga at Chhapra in Bihar. The Koshi, okay, that originates from the north of the Mount Everest in Tibet, where it is known as Arun. Okay, Koshi River is also known as called Arun Sea, as you can see, right? Which river is also known as called that? Originating from Garhwal Hills near Girisain, the Ram Ganga joins the Ganga near Kannauj. The Damodar drains the eastern margins of Chota Nagpur Plateaus, where it flows through a rift valley and finally joins the Hooghly. Okay, the Barkar is the main tributary of the Damodar. Okay, next it says, originating from Darjeeling Hills, the Mahanadi joins the Ganga as its last left bank tributary in West Bengal. Originating from Amarkantak Plateau, the Sun is the largest, is the large south bank tributary of the Ganga. It joins the Ganga at Arha in Bihar. Okay, next we are talking about the Brahmaputra River. Okay, the Brahmaputra is one of the major river, as you know, guys. Alright, so Brahmaputra originates from where it's originated, that is called your Chemyungdung Glacier of Kailash Range near Mansarovar Lake. In Tibet, the Brahmaputra is known as Sangpo. Okay, which means, what is the meaning of Sangpo? Sangpo means purifier. Okay, the Rengo Sangpo is the major right bank tributary of Brahmaputra in Tibet. The Brahmaputra enters in India near the west of Sadia town in Arunachal Pradesh. Okay, this is important, from where the Brahmaputra enters into India, the west of Sadia town in Arunachal Pradesh. The major left bank tributaries of Brahmaputra are Lohit, Dibang, Sikang, Bhuri, Dingi and Dhansari. मेजर राइट बैंक ट्रिब्यूटरीज ऑफ ब्रह्मपुत्र आर सबनसिरी, कमेंग, मनास एंड संकोश. नाउ गाइज, हियर इज द मैप वेर यू कैन सी द वेर दिस हाउ योर ब्रह्मपुत्र ओरिजिनेट, राइट. इट स्टार्ट फ्रॉम हियर एंड दिस इज हाउ इट मूव्स एंड इट एंटर्स इन टू इंडिया, हियर ब्रह्मपुत्र, राइट. And this it comes here into the Bay of Bengal over here. Okay, these are the small, as I told you, Lohit, and these are the another small river. Okay, Sabansiri, etc. Okay, this is what it is. Okay, and this is the flow of your river Ganges, which goes like this. Okay, it mixes over here, and this is your river Yamuna. Okay, so these are the major three rivers: the Yamuna, Ganga, and Brahmaputra. You should know the location. Do practice in the map for the better performance. Okay guys, next we have our peninsular river system. The peninsular drainage system is older than Himalayan river system. Okay, the Mahanadi originates from Shiawa. Okay, it originates from Shiawa in Raipur district of Chhattisgarh and runs through Madhya Pradesh, Odisha, and finally discharges its water into Bay of Bengal. The total length of Mahanadi is 851 km, popularly known as Dakshin Ganga. Okay, which river is also known as called Dakshin Ganga? So that is your Mahanadi. Okay, Dakshin Ganga, the Godavari, is the largest peninsular river system. The Godavari originates from Nasik district of Maharashtra and discharges water into Bay of Bengal. With total of 1465 km, Godavari covers the area of Maharashtra, Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, Odisha and Andhra Pradesh. Okay, the Pain Ganga, the Indravati, the Pranhita and the Manjra are the major tributaries of Godavari. Originates from Mahabaleshwar in Sahyadri. The Krishna is the second largest east flowing peninsular river. Further, it says the Koyna and Tungabhadra, which is in Karnataka, and Bhima are the major tributaries of Krishna. On the total catchment area of Krishna, 27% lies in Maharashtra. Okay, it means 27% in Maharashtra, 44% in Karnataka and 29% in Andhra Pradesh. Okay, it means a big part of Krishna River flows in Karnataka. Okay, then after it is in Maharashtra and the third is at the Andhra Pradesh. The Kaveri originates from the Brahmagiri Hills. Okay, that is 1341 meters, located at Kogadu district in Karnataka. Okay, this is from where your Kaveri originates from. Okay, now in this map guys, you can see the peninsular rivers of India, which are the major river. This is your Narmada, here is your Tapi. See, Narmada and Tapi are the close by, and here we have Mahanadi, this is Godavari, Krishna and Kaveri. Okay, in order to remember that, you can just take the initials of this all the rivers, right? So it can be formed like N from here, M, then T, G, K, K, right? So this way you can make it, and just for your, like, you know, learning purpose, it may help you out guys. Okay, you can have a clear look of this, the map, if you wish, right? Okay, the next point says the river Kaveri's total course of 770 km commands a basin area of about 8.8 million hectare, of which 3% lies in Kerala, 41% lies in Karnataka, 56% lies in Tamil Nadu. Major tributaries of Kaveri are Kabini, Bhavani and Amravati. Okay, the Narmada originates from the western flank of Amarkantak Plateau. Okay, this is from where the Narmada originates, from the Amarkantak Plateau. Okay, that is 10757 meter high. Okay, flowing through the Rift Valley located near Satpura in the south and the Vandhya Range in the north, the Narmada forms Dhunandhar waterfalls. Okay, Dhunandhar waterfalls and a picturesque gorge of marble rocks near Jabalpur. Here is a picture, guys. This is the picture of your Dhunandhar waterfalls, right? It is in Jabalpur. Okay, you can see that how beautiful it is, right? Okay, the total length of Narmada is 1312. Okay, it's quite easy to remember, 1312 kilometer. Flowing in the westward direction, Narmada finally empties into the Arabian Sea in Bharuch district of Gujarat. Originating from Multaj in the Betul district of Madhya Pradesh, Tapi is the other important westward flowing, okay, it's westward flowing river emptying into the Arabian Sea. About 79% of Tapi basin lies in Maharashtra, 15% of it's in Madhya Pradesh and 6% is in Gujarat. Luni is the longest river system of Rajasthan. Okay, primarily Luni originated in the Pushkar Valley of the Aravali. Okay, पुष्कर वैली ऑफ अरावली रेंज राजस्थान राजस्थान इन टू ब्रांचेस दैट इज द सरस्वती एंड साबरमती विच जॉइंस ईच अदर एट गोविंदगढ़ ओके फ्रॉम हियर द रिवर नोन एज लूनी ओके नाउ गाइज इन दिस टेबल यू कैन सी दिस फॉलोइंग टेबल इलस्ट्रेट द मेजर डिफरेंस बिटवीन द हिमालयन रिवर्स एंड द पेनिनसुलर रिवर दैट वॉट इज द डिफरेंस ओके फर्स्ट इज द प्लेस ऑफ ओरिजिन द हिमालयन माउंटेन्स एंड कवर्ड विद ग्लेशियर एंड दिस पेनिनसुलर रिवर्स दे आर ओरिजिनेटेड इन द पेनिनसुलर प्लेटू और सेंट्रल आइलैंड एंड द नेचर ऑफ फ्लो इज दिस इज कॉल्ड पेरिनियल दे आर रिसीव वाटर फ्रॉम द ग्लेशियर एंड रेनफॉल ओके एंड दिस पेनिनसुलर रिवर्स दे आर सीजनल डिपेंड ऑन मानसून रेनफॉल ओके वैन वी टॉक अबाउट द टाइप ऑफ ड्रेनेज दे हैव सो दैट इज एंटीसीडेंट एंड कंसिक्वेंट लीडिंग टू डेंड्रिटिक पैटर्न ऑफ प्लेन्स ओके एंड दिस वन इन पेनिनसुलर इट इज सुपर इम्पोज्ड रिजुविनेटेड रिजल्टिंग इन ट्रेल्स रेडियल एंड रेक्टेंगुलर पैटर्न ओके एंड द नेचर ऑफ रिवर ऑफ हिमालयन रिवर इज दे आर लॉन्ग कोर्स फ्लोइंग थ्रू द रग्ड माउंटेन एक्सपीरियंसिंग हीट वाड इरोजन एंड रिवर कैप्चरिंग इन प्लेन्स मैंडरिंग एंड शिफ्टिंग ऑफ कोर्स ओके अदर हैंड द पेनिनसुलर रिवर्स इफ यू लुक एट द नेचर ऑफ पेनिनसुलर रिवर दे आर स्मॉलर द फिक्स्ड कोर्स विद द वेल एडजस्टेड वैलीज If you look at their catchment area, so they are very large basin, Himalayan rivers and peninsular rivers are relatively smaller basin. Age of the Himalayan rivers, they are very young and youthful, active and deepening into the in the valleys. And this peninsular rivers, they are old rivers and grab profile and have almost reached their base levels. Okay, so guys, this is how we have covered the topic of our drainage system or the river systems in India. So in this video, this much is enough. I will come up with the next video with the more detail on it. Okay. Bye bye and have a nice day.